everyone, my name is Tianlein and today I present you the second episode of Tamriel's Next Top Model for the Elder Scrolls Online. Today's outfit theme is big and badass. A big thank you to all participants for their great outfit submissions. As always, you can find timestamps in the video description if you are only interested in a specific topic. The first outfit is created by myself and presented by my character Gunhilde die Schöne. Gunhilde is not only a beauty, she's also a strong and tough orc woman. I used for the head the heavy frostcaster style, the chest the medium orc tongue style, the shoulders the heavy hollowjack style, the hands the heavy skin changer style, the waist the heavy knot 3 style, the legs the heavy hollowjack style, and the feet the heavy skin changer style. As weapons, Gunhilde uses a greatsword in a Sifkin style. To dye Gunhilde's gear, I used Motif Master Brown, Master Gold and ranked 10 materials dice. The application cost for this outfit is around 6700 gold. Now I share with you the outfit from Fnord Enoch. Fnord loves the look of the Tyranny helm and skin changer chest and wanted to create a good looking outfit for his Nightblade. He used for the head the heavy Tyranny style, the chest the heavy skin changer style, the shoulders the heavy Khajiit 4 style, the hands the heavy Dark Elf 4 style, the waist the heavy Primal style, the legs the heavy Ebon Shadow style, and the feet the heavy Dark Elf style. As weapons he uses two swords, one in the Hollowjack style and one in the Daedric style. As dice he uses rank 6 materials dice and rank 5 materials dice. The application cost for this outfit is around 7100 gold. The next outfit is from someone who has a really long account name. You can find his name in the left corner of the screen. His character, Wilgefors of Erinorn, is a brave and proud member of the Altmeri Dominion. He went through the city of Ash, where he got heavily injured. But he is proud to serve his homeland and gladly sacrifices his life for the Dominion and the Queen. He used for the chest the light Dark Elf Rope 4 style, the shoulders the heavy High Elf 3 style, the hands the medium Dark Elf 1 style, the waist the heavy High Elf 4 style, the legs the light High Elf 1 style, and the feet the medium High Elf 4 style. The helmet is hidden. As weapons he uses two staves, one in the Wood Elf 2 style and the other one in the High Elf 1 style. As dice he uses Talmor Black, Starlight Gold and Cold Harbor Ash Black. The application cost for this outfit is around 1000 gold. The next outfit is from Lone Wolf. His character Lupo Solitaire is a Magicka Dragon Knight. The story of his character began when he was thrown into the Red Mountain. Deep inside the volcano, his charred body touched the heart of Lorcan, and he received the gift of immense firepower. He used for the head the Winter Corsage Boardroom hat, the chest the heavy Outlaw style, the shoulders the heavy Wood Elf 3 style, the hands the light Thief's Guild style, the waist the medium Hollowjack style, the legs the heavy Skin Changer style, and the feet the heavy Dark Elf 3 style. As weapons he uses a sword in a Daedric style and a shield in a Soulshaven style. As dice he uses Cold Harbor Ash Black and Daedric Red. He also uses the Bloodforge skin which you can purchase at the Crown Store. The application cost for this outfit is around 4000 gold. Now I share with you the outfit from Giz. His character Starborn is an ancient Yokudan warrior, called by the Celestial Warrior. He dons an ancient armor. At some point he was sent to the Clockwork City where he changed his color and mechanized himself and his outfit. He used for the chest the heavy Ragada 4 style, the shoulders the heavy Apostle style, the hands the heavy High Elf 4 style, the waist the light Redguard 4 style, the legs the heavy Ragada style and the feet the heavy Dark Elf 4 style. The helmet is hidden. As weapons he uses a sword in the Apostle style and a shield in the Redoran style. As dice he uses Hunting's Gold, a Teak Brass and Master Gold. The application cost for this outfit is around 13,000 gold. Now I present you the outfit from Hexes. He wanted to create a dark, strong and badass looking appearance for his sorcerer and sorceress. He used for the chest the medium mercenary style, the shoulders the light Ebonheart Pact style, the hands the heavy Abbas Watch style, the waist the light Breton 4 style, the legs the light Celestial style, and the feet the light Dark Brotherhood style. The helm is hidden, but he uses as facial accessories the Sacred Rhombus Circlet, which you can get from the Scalecaller Crown Crates. As weapon he uses a Lichtstaff, but that motif's at the moment not obtainable as an outfit style. You can also use the Even Shadow, Militant Order or Akaviri style. As dyes, he uses Prefect's Grey, Legat's Black and Palatine's White. To enhance his look even more, he uses as a hairstyle the Dominion Warlocks, and for the eyes, the Oracle Eyes. Additionally, he uses the Talvani Magister personality. The application cost for this outfit is around 5,390 gold. The next outfit submission is from the Joker. He was so lucky and obtained from the Scapegoat Crown Crates a new frost mount. His idea was to create a snow warrior which works well together with the cold and frosty look of the Frostbane Bear mount. He used for the head the medium Redguard 2 style, the chest the medium Ashlander style, the shoulders the light Soulshriven style, the hands the medium Skinchanger style, the waist the light Glass style, the legs the medium Minotaur style and the feet the heavy Ashlander style. As weapons he uses two swords in the Ancient Orc style and a bow in the Ashlander style. As dyes he uses Banded Brown and Uranus White. The application cost for this outfit is around 15,050 gold. The following outfit was submitted by Disabled Panda. His character Aria the Shadow got tired of her office job, so she decided to quit her job and explore Tamriel. He used for the head the medium Yokudan style, the chest the medium Ebonheart Pact style, the shoulders the heavy Imperial Force style, the hands the medium Celestial style, the waist the heavy Sifkin style, the legs the medium Abbas Watch style and the feet the medium Tremor style. As weapons he uses a sword in the Barbaric 3 style and an axe in the Celestial style. As dyes he uses the Colossus Brass and the Cold Harbor Ash Black. The application cost for this outfit is around 8,000 gold. The next outfit was submitted by Draken28. He acquired the Infernal Epidermis skin and wanted to create a fiery themed Argonian character. The result is Place and Fires, which looks really badass. He used for the chest the medium Argonian 1 style, the shoulders the heavy Wood Elf 4 style, the hands the light Assassin's League style, the waist the heavy Primal style, the legs the heavy Hollowjack style and the feet the heavy Dark Brotherhood style. The helm is hidden. As weapons he uses a battle axe in a Soulshriven style. As dyes he uses Cold Harbor Ash Black, Tamar Black and Windhelm Steel. The application cost for this outfit is around 5,025 gold. Now we take a look at the outfit from Anuxius. His character is a heavily armored mercenary who is roaming around Tamriel to gain reputation as the Bull Knight and find treasures and glory. He used for the head the heavy Minotaur style, the chest the heavy Skinchanger style, the shoulders the heavy Imperial Force style, the hands the heavy Dark Brotherhood style, the waist the heavy Skinchanger style, the legs the heavy Trinimax style and the feet the heavy Trinimax style. As weapons he uses an axe in the Trinimax style and a shield in the Ebonheart Pack style. As dyes he uses Obsidian Black and Cold Harbor Ash Black. The application cost for this outfit is around 8,600 gold. Now I present you the outfit from Hylor 3. He created a cool and stylish looking outfit. His character is an Imperial who joined the cause of the Ebonheart Pact. He used for the head the medium Trinimax style, the chest the light mercenary robe style, the shoulders the light silken ring style, the hands the heavy Order of the Hour style, the waist the medium Xivkin style and the feet the heavy Militant Ordinator style. As weapons he uses a sword in the Ebon Shadow style and the shield in the Dreadhorn style and also a great sword in the Soulshriven style. As dyes he uses Noxophilic Black, Marmor Ice Grey and Obsidian Black. The application cost for this outfit is around 12,650 gold. The following outfit to Seen Brood is submitted by Greenhawk. At the threat of Daedric Alliance forms in Somerset, Hussein gathers his hounds to form an army. The title of Brood only falls to the strongest berserkers that Hussein could find. He used for the head the heavy Skinchanger style, the chest the heavy Nord 3 style, the shoulders the medium Bloodforge style, the hands the heavy Skinchanger style, the waist the light Skinchanger style, the legs the heavy Nord 4 style and the feet the heavy Skinchanger style. As weapons he uses a battle axe in the Breton 3 style and two axes in the Breton 3 style. As dyes he uses various colors, for example Lycanthrope Grey, Cold Harbor Ash Black and Ziffern Red. The application cost for this outfit is around 7,800 gold. Thank you very much for your awesome outfit submissions. You did all an amazing job and came up with special and unique outfit ideas. I enjoyed all the different ideas of the topic Big and Badass, and thanks again to all participants. For the third episode of Tamil's Next Top Model, I thought we'd take the theme Assassins and Thieves. If you want to submit your outfit, be sure to take a look at the description where you can find the instructions. Hopefully you enjoyed the second episode of Tamil's Next Top Model. Which outfit did you like the most? Thanks for watching, and it would be wonderful if you subscribe, like, or leave me a comment. Have a good day, and until next time, tschüss!